Hello everyone. In this video, we will read chapter 4 of class 7, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom, a Japanese story of a kind old couple and their dog. Before we read, this is a story about an honest and hardworking old couple and their pet dog. The neighbors are troublesome and the dog dies a sad death. The spirit of dog gives solace. Solace means comfort or consolation in a time of distress or sadness, and support to his master in unexpected ways. So this story is about an honest and hardworking couple and their pet dog. Their neighbors are troublesome and sadly the dog dies. But the soul of dog gives comfort to his master in an unusual way. So let's see the story, The Ashes That Made Trees Bloom. In the good old days of the daimyos, daimyos are 19th century rich and wealthy landowners. There lived an old couple whose only pet was a little dog. Having no children, they loved it as though it were a baby. The old dame means an elderly woman, made it a cushion of blue crepe, and at mealtime, Muko, for that was its name, would sit on it as snug. Snug means comfortable, as any cat. The kind people fed the pet with tidbits. Tidbits means small pieces of fish from their own chopsticks and all the boiled rice it wanted. Thus treated, the dumb creature loved its protectors like a being with a soul. A being with a soul means like a human child showing emotions. So in the good old days of daimyos, there were an old couple who loved their pet dog Muko. Muko was the name of the dog. So they loved him very much, so much that the old lady made a cushion of blue cloth for him, and at the mealtime, at food time, Muko would sit comfortably on the cushion. The kind people used to feed tidbits of fish to this dog from their own chopstick and all the boiled rice, and thus kindly treated the dumb creature, here refers to the dog, loved his owner as though he was their own child. The old man, being a rice farmer, went daily with hoe or spade into the fields, working hard from morning until O Tento Sama. O Tento Sama is a Japanese word for sun, had gone down behind the hills. Every day the dog followed him to work, never once harming the white heron that walked in the footstep of old man. White heron is a bird, to pick up the worms. For the old fellow was patient and kind to everything that had life, and often turned up, that means dug up, a sod on purpose means intentionally, to give food to the birds. So this old man was a rice farmer who used to work in his field from morning till evening. He used to go to field with his hoe and spade. So every day the dog used to follow his master, never ever harming white heron that used to walk behind his master to pick up the worm that would turn up from his footsteps. And the old man was also patient and kind to every creature, and he used to even dig the soil intentionally to give food to the birds. One day the dog came running to him, putting his paws against his legs and motioning with his head to some spot behind. The old man at first thought his pet was only playing and did not mind it. But the dog kept on whining. Whining means making a long, high-pitched sound and running to and fro for some minutes. So one day Muko came running to his master, motioning, pointing towards certain spot. The old man first thought that Muko was just playing and did not pay attention. But when the dog kept whining and running to that spot, the old man followed the dog a few yards to a place where the animal began a lively scratching. Thinking it was possibly a buried bone or bit of fish, the old man stuck his hoe in the earth a pile of gold gleamed means shine before him. So when the dog didn't stop whining, the old man followed the dog to a place where Muko started scratching. The old man thought that it was a buried fish or bone, thinking that he stuck the weapon on the ground and a pile of gold shined before him. Thus, in an hour, the old couple were made rich. The good soul brought a piece of land, made a feast. Feast means a large meal in celebration for their friends, and gave plenty to their poor neighbors. As for the dog, they petted him till they nearly smothered him with kindness. Smothered means, actually it means suffocation, but here it means they gave him a lot of love. So within an hour, the old couple became rich. They made feast, they made celebration, large food for their friends, and they also gave enough money to poor neighbors. And they loved their dog very much. Now, in the same village, there lived a wicked old man and his wife, not a bit sensitive and kind, who had always kicked and scolded all dogs whenever any passed their house. Hearing of their neighbor's good luck, they coaxed. Coaxed means enticed, persuaded, making greed to the dog, into the garden, and set before him bits of fish and other dainties. Dainties means tasty food, hoping he would find treasure for them. But the dog, being afraid of cruel pair, would neither eat nor move. So in the same village, there lived a wicked and evil couple with an old man and his wife. They were not at all sensitive or kind towards animals, and they used to kick and scold all the dogs whoever passes through their house. But hearing about their neighbor's good luck, they tried to coax Muko into their garden. They tried to persuade Muko to come to their garden by giving him fish and other tasty food, and they hoped that Muko would find treasure for them as well. But the dog was very afraid of the cruel pair, and he did not eat and he did not even move. Then they dragged him out of the doors, taking a spade and hoe with them. No sooner had the dog got near a pine tree growing in the garden, then he began to paw and scratch the ground as if a mighty treasure lay beneath. Beneath means underneath. So then they dragged Muko out of their door toward the garden, and as the dog reached near a pine tree, he started scratching on the ground as if there was a treasure there. "Quick, wife, hand me the spade and hoe," cried the greedy old fellow, and he danced with joy. Then the covetous means greedy, old fellow with a spade and the old crone means old woman, with a hoe began to dig. But there was nothing but a dead kitten, the smell of which made them drop their tools and shut their noses. Furious means very angry at the dog, the old man kicked and bit him to death. And the old woman finished the work by nearly chopping off his head with a sharp hoe. They then flung means threw him into hole and heaped the earth over his carcass. Carcass means dead body. Now when Muko pointed towards a place and scratching, the old man was very happy. He thought Muko has found treasure. And the greedy man told his wife to bring hoe, and they began to dig. But they found nothing but a dead kitten. It was so smelly that they had to drop their tools and shut their noses. And they became very angry at the dog. And the old man kicked the dog and bet him to death, and the old woman chopped, that means cut into pieces, his head, and then they threw him into a hole and buried his dead body. The owner of the dog heard of the death of his pet, and mourning for him as if he had been his own child, went at night under the pine tree. He set up some bamboo tubes in the ground, such as are used for tombs, in which he put fresh flowers. Then he laid a cup of water and a tray of food on the grave and burned several costly sticks of incense. He mourned a great while over his pet, calling him many dear names as if he were alive. So when the kind old man heard of Muko's death, he was so sad. He went to the place where he was buried near the pine tree, and he set up a tomb for him. He put some bamboo sticks like they put for tomb, and he kept some fresh flour and water there, and he stayed and he burned several costly incense sticks, some good smelling sticks, and he mourned for his dead for a while, calling him many good names, many nice names, dear names, as if he was alive. That night the spirit of dog appeared to him in a dream and said, "Cut down the pine tree over my grave and make from it a mortar." Mortar means a bowl for your rice pastry, and a mill for your bean sauce. So that night Muku came in the dream of that old man and he said, cut down the pine tree and make a bowl out of it and a mill for your bean sauces. Bowl for rice pastry and mill for bean sauces. Bean sauce. So the old man chopped down the tree and cut out of the middle of the trunk section about 2 feet long. With great labor, partly by fire and partly by chisel. Chisel is a sharp weapon. He scraped out a hollow space as big as a small bowl. So the man did as Muko has told him in dreams. He cut down the pine tree and made a bowl out of it. Half by fire, half by a sharp device. He then made a long handle hammer of wood, such as is used for pounding rice. He also made a long hammer, which is used for crushing rice. When the New Year's time drew near, he wished to make some rice pastry. When the rice was all boiled, Granny put it into the mortar. The old man lifted his hammer to pound the mass into dough, and the blows fell heavy and fast till the pastry was all ready for baking. So during New Year, the old man desired to make rice pastry. So he boiled the rice and the old woman put the rice into the mortar, into the bowl that he has crafted out of the pine tree. And then this old man lifted his hammer to grind the rice and he made very heavy blows on the rice until the pastry was ready for baking. Suddenly, the whole mass turned into a heap of gold coins. When the old woman took the handmill and filling it with the beans began to grind, the gold drops like rain. Now, as soon as he was trying to make pastry, suddenly the whole mass of rice turned into gold coins. And the old woman was also, who was handling the mill to make bean sauce, that also became gold and it dropped out of the device. Meanwhile, the envious neighbor peeped at the window when the boiled beans were being grounded. Envious means jealous. So meanwhile, the jealous neighbor were also looking at that one when the boiled beans were being grounded, when it was being crushed, and they saw that everything has turned into gold. Goody me, cried the old hag as she saw each dripping of sauce turning into gold, yellow gold, until in a few minutes the tub under the meal was full of shining mass of gold. So she saw everything, that the rice pastry, the bean sauce, all was turning into gold. So the old couple were rich again. The next day, the stingy means greedy or miserly, and wicked neighbor came and borrowed the mortar and the magic meal. They filled one with boiled rice and the other with beans. Then the old man began to pound and the women to grind. But at the first blow and turn, the pastry and sauce turned into foul mass of worms. Still more angry at this, they chopped the meal into pieces to use as wood fire. So now next day, these miser people went to the neighbor and borrowed their mortar and magic meal. And they filled one with rice and other with beans. And as the old man was trying to pound and the women was about to grind, instead of turning into gold, all the pastry turned into worms, a foul mass of worms. That means it all turned into bad smelling worms. Now these greedy couple got more angry and they cut the meal into pieces and used it as firewood. They used it to make fire. This was part one. Now let's see part second. Not long after that, the good old man dreamed again and the spirit of dog spoke to him, telling him how the wicked people had burned the mill made from the pine tree. Take the ashes of mill, sprinkle them on the withered trees. Withered trees means bare and dry trees, and they will bloom again, said the dog spirit. So now again the dog spirit came in the dream of the kind person and told him that the wicked couple has burned the mill of the pine tree. And then he told that take the ashes are what remains after burning a wood. So the dog said, take those ashes and sprinkle, put this on withered tree. Withered trees are old and dry trees that has almost died. And he said that if you put the ashes on the withered tree, the trees will bloom. The old man awoke and went at once to his wicked neighbor's house, where he found the miserable old pair. Miserable means hopeless old pair, sitting at the edge of their square fire space in the middle of floor, smoking and spinning. From time to time, they warmed their hands and feet with the blaze. So the kind person got up and went to the neighbor, and he saw that they were sitting in at a place and they had made fire of the pine tree and they were warming their hands from that. Some bits of meal, while behind them lay a pile of broken pieces. So they were warming their hands with the fire, and behind them there was a pile of the broken pieces. The good old man humbly asked for ashes, though the covetous couple turned up their noses. Turned up their noses means they were treating him badly with hatred. Him and scolded him as if he were a thief. They let him fill his basket with the ashes, though they did not behave well with the good person, but they let him take the basket of ashes. On coming home, the old man took his wife into garden. It being winter, their favorite cherry tree was bare. So the man took his wife to the garden, and since it was winter, their favorite cherry tree, it was bare. That means there were no leaves, no flowers on the tree. He sprinkled a pinch of ashes on it, and lo, it sprouted blossoms until it became a cloud of pink blooms which perfumed the air. The news of this filled the village and everyone ran out to see the wonder. So now, as soon as he put the ashes on the tree, it blossomed. That means it started giving flowers and leaves and it became very beautiful. And the place was filled with nice smell. And the news of this filled the village and everyone ran out to see this wonder. The covetous couple also heard the story and gathered up the remaining ashes of the milk, kept them to make withered tree blossom. The kind old man, hearing that his lord, the daimyo, was to pass along the high road near the village, set out to see him, taking his basket of ashes. As the train approached, he climbed up into the old withered cherry tree and stood by the wayside. So when the greedy couple heard about this blossoming story, they kept all the remaining ashes in a bucket so that they can wither the they can blossom the withered tree. And when the kind old man heard that his lord, his master, daimyo, was passing near their place, he took the basket of ashes, and as the procession, train means procession, of the daimyo approached, he put ashes on the withered tree on the side. Now, in the days of the daimyos, it was custom that when their lord passed by, for all the loyal people to shut up their windows. They even pasted them fast with slip of paper so as not to commit the impertinence. Impertinence means not showing respect, of looking down on his lordship. All the people along the road would fall upon their hands and knees and remain prostrate. Prostrate means lying on ground with faces downward until the procession passed by. Now, in the old days, if you look at your master in your eyes, that was a crime. So everybody has to stay inside, shut their doors, and if the people were on road, they have to lie down with their face towards the road. The train drew near. One tall, competent man, competent means capable man, was leading the procession. He was crying out to people to get down on their knees. Suddenly, the leader of the van saw an old man, an aged man, on the tree. He was about to shout on that aged man, but seeing that he was old fellow, he pretended that he has not noticed him and he just went. So when the daimyo's palki drew near, palki is the place where the daimyo was sitting. The old man took a pinch of ashes from his basket and he scattered it on the trees. And within a moment, the tree bursted into blossom. The daimyo was very delighted and he ordered the train to stop and he went out to see. And he called the old man. He thanked him and ordered to present silk robes, sponge cakes, fans, and other rewards to be given to him. He even invited this old man to his castle. So now this old man went gleefully. Gleefully means happily, to share this joyous news with his old wife. But the greedy neighbor also heard of it, and he took out some magic ashes and went on the highway. There he waited until the daimyo's train came near, and instead of kneeling down like crowd, he climbed on withered cherry tree. And when the daimyo himself was almost directly under the tree, under him, where he was climbing on the tree, He threw a handful of ashes over the tree and did not change a particle, but this did not change anything. In fact, the wind blew the fine dust of the ashes into the nose and eyes of the Daimyo, and hence choking him and his wife. It spoiled all the pomp and dignity of the procession. So all the pomp, all the show and dignity of the procession was spoiled. And the man whose business is to tell everyone to get down on knees seized the old fellow, that means caught the old fellow by collar, and he dragged him from the tree and brought him towards, he put him into a ditch, beating him soundly and left him there for dead. So this, when the this bad person put ashes on trees, nothing changed. In fact, the ashes went into the eyes and nose of the Daimyo, hence choking them. So this man was brought and he was thrown into a ditch and he was left there to die. Thus the wicked old man died in the mud, but the kind friend of the dog dwelt in peace and plenty, and both he and his wife lived to a green old age. Green old age means a prosperous life. So wicked old man was left there to die at the ditch, and this kind people lived their life happily. So this was a Japanese tale written by William Elliot Griffiths. So this was quite a long story, students, but it was very inspiring story, and I hope you have learned something from here. So this was about the video. Thank you for listening. Bye bye. Take care.